Hello and welcome to video related to steps for evaluating the results for entered DAX measures. In previous videos, we have learnt about calculated columns, calculated measures, evaluation context, and filter propagation. We noted that filter information flows from lookup tables to fact tables. Now, in this video, we will look into little more details how the final results for DAX formulas for a calculated measures are being determined. Kindly note that I am referring to calculated measures and not to calculated columns. So to explain the steps or rules about how calculation happens in the backend for any DAX measures before the results is being displayed on the screen, I would like to take a simple example of counting the balls from this particular jar. Imagine that there is a jar having balls of a different colors like this, yellow color, blue color, green color, and red color balls. Now these balls are spread within this jar and have not been arranged at all. So imagine that there are four people and each one of them is having their own favorite color. So he or she is interested only in those color balls. So person 1 is interested only in red colored balls and he will count those balls only. Similarly for other people, they will count only the balls of their favorite colors. So to count these balls from this particular jar by each person, all of them will follow a three-step process. The first step is like each person has to decide what color ball they are going to be counting. So here each one of them is having their own favorite color, so they will be counting the balls of that colors only. Next step is like once the color has been decided, it is to separate all of these colored balls into a separate small jars like this. So red colored person will count only the red colored balls and he will separate only those balls into a separate jar. Similar is case with other people's also. And finally, the third step is like once we have all the balls separated, it is very easy to count all of them one by one. So each person will count their own favorite colored balls. So I hope you have found these steps very obvious and intuitive. It is just three step process. First, decide the color which you want to count. Second is separate the relevant balls. And finally, count them. Now, the calculation which happens for DAX measures in the background applies the similar steps to come up with the results. Here, first step is deciding the items to be considered or filtered out from your table. It is just like deciding the colors which you are interested in and counting those balls. The items which needs to be filtered will be picked up by DAX engine from your visuals, slicers, page level filters, report level filters, or row and column headers. If you have selected any single item or multiple items in this are selected, all of them will be considered. Then the second step is like separating the balls into a small balls. In similar way, your fact table or a big table will be separated into a virtual small table by DAX engine in its memory. So all of the items which has been identified by step 1 will be separated into this virtual table. So all of this happens in memory and it won't be visible to you on screen. So everything happens in the backstage only. And finally, we perform the count of balls which has been separated. So in similar way, the aggregation or mathematical operations are then performed on the records which are being filtered in virtual table. So based on the DAX aggregation functions which you are using, those mathematical operations will be performed finally. So to summarize the steps, values of filter are taken from the various fields. Then the records of items to be filtered out are done from big table into a virtual small table. And finally, the mathematical operation or aggregation happens. So with that, I hope it is easier to look at directly inside Power BI. So let us revisit the matrix visuals which we have seen in previous video. So in this matrix visual, the first step of deciding what items to be filtered is taking the initial filter context or filter coordinates. In current scenario, this initial filter context values are taken from row headers and column headers and even from the slicers as well. Further, we do not have any other visuals or even fields are not being filtered out from these visual filters. So those won't be considered for filtering the relevant values. So Before moving on to the second step, let us consider this accessories as our sample example. So here the coordinates are coming from city and from product categories. So this will be a ballad and this will be accessory. So second step is finding out the relevant records in our sales table where this measure has been documented, and finally performing that mathematical operations. So before that, using this ballad and accessories, the items needs to be filtered out in sales table. So let us first of all go to our diagram view and see how the information will flow. So first of all, the ballad city will be identified in this table. It will flow down through relationship in customer. So in customer, we have this geography key common between this geography table and customer table. So based on the geography key for city, all of the customer values are getting filtered out. So using that customer key and sales customer relationship, so all of these customer values will then flow down to sales, and only the details for those customers will be visible in this sales in virtual table. Similarly for categories, it will flow down accessories from this table to this subcategory, from subcategory to products, and only the products which are having category of accessories will get selected, and it will then flow down to sales table. So all of the products which are having category as product and customer having city as ballad will get selected from this sales table. So to take an example, now here if you see, we will see the geography table first of all, and our city was ballad. So let us select ballad here, and here you can see that geography key is 607. So this key will then flow down to customer table, and it will filter out only those customer which are tagged with this customer key. So let us click OK. Now since there are multiple customers, I won't do it one by one, but all of these customers values will then flow down to sales table, and only the relevant values will get displayed. And finally, since we are using sum of sales amount, that sales amount will get totaled out for this particular column. So that will be the final step for aggregation or mathematical operations. So all of these steps are being performed in the background at a lightning speed. Hence, the results for all of these sales are being displayed immediately the moment you drag and drop your calculated measures to visuals area. And this happens for each of the sales separately, since each of the cell will have a separate coordinates. So here for bikes and ballad, we have 41,000. So here again, we have a separate coordinates. So I hope this three-step process is very clear to you now. These steps form the foundation for any calculated measures created using DAX. Hence, this is very important concept which you should learn. There are more nuances to these three steps and also few exceptions to these three steps as well. However, I will explain those nuances in later part of the course. For the time being, I don't want you to confuse or overload with complexity of this topic. Just remember these three steps for the timing and continue on with this course. So that is it from my side, guys. See you in next video.